If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, if you're the kind who takes the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place for people like you. If you stand up for those down on their knees and lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light, give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with your heart on your sleeve, and if you're trying to be the change you wanna see, if you lay down your life for love so someone could be saved, there's a place for people like you. Streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you.
Oh, Because of a mighty rush. And it's close than it's ever been. I can almost hear the trumpet.
And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yes, said the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. And God will wipe away all tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Welcome to everyone who has come from far and from near to join with the family of the deceased to give God thanks for the life he has allowed his handmaid to live. And if I'm correct, that would be some 83 years. It's a time of thanksgiving. She has lived, and God has decided that her time on earth is ended. As the Bible says, in everything we ought to give God thanks. His will is not ours. Amen. But whatever God does, it is well done. So welcome, welcome to everyone. And I will just start and then hand over as we sing the opening hymn. Then we have the opening prayer. And then the moderators will take over and guide us through the program. Welcome to the ministers on the platform. We have Bishop Gordon, Pastor Carlton Burton, resident pastor, and for the family, be strong. Be strong. Let's sing the first hymn on the program together. Then Pastor Carlton Burton will come and do the opening prayer, and the moderator, who is Deacon Guilford Copes, a son, and missionary Pauline Tate, will be moderating today's service. I must ask, as much as is possible, keep your mask on. It's a requirement by law that in places where persons are assembled, that we do so. Please. Some glad morning, some glad morning, when this life is o'er, I'll fly away to our home and God's celestial shore. Somebody, praise God. We remain still and quiet as we bow our heads. as we invite Pastor Carlton Burton to come, do the opening prayer, and then the moderators will take over from here and lead.
Praise God. Shall we bless the Lord? Praise God. Good morning to each and everyone. Praise God. No, Sister Portia's wonderful woman of God. Praise God. Many times I went to look for her. Praise God. I shared the word, and she would cry when the anointing is upon her. Praise God. And we know that Sister Portia is a wonderful woman of God. And yes, she will greatly miss. Praise God. Let us pray. Most righteous, eternal Father, King of the universe, giver and sustainer of life. Father, we worship you. We honor you, mighty God, for the life of your daughter, mighty God. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, that, Lord, you will cover the family even now, O loving God. Because, Lord, you know, O mighty God, how we feel in our heart even now. Loving God, even Lazarus died, you wept, not because you could not call him from the dead, but because you are touched with our infirmity, O glory to God. Hallelujah. And this morning, O God, you know our pain, Father. So I pray in the name of Jesus that you will strengthen us, O mighty God. Lord, I pray, oh God, for even the family right now will be grieving. Oh God Almighty, you who know how to comfort us this morning. And Father, we bless you. We give you thanks. Loving God, and I know, Lord, you will get the glory, Father. Because we know, mighty God, as your word declared, to live is Christ and to die is gain. Father, we know that, oh God, Christian never died and only say goodbye. And Lord, we know, mighty God, one day we'll be see her again. Oh, glory to God. And I pray for those of us that live here, God, we will live a life, oh mighty God, that's when our day of departure is come, we will come home to you. Father, we ask you, Lord, to just take full control. Lead and direct, almighty God, as we wait upon you. We give you thanks. In Jesus' name I pray, and all of God's children say, amen. Amen.
Bless the Lord, church. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. We are here this morning to celebrate the life of Mistress Myrtle Portius. JK, you are blocking somebody. Can you please go and give way? Thank you. 8715 JK. Mistress Myrtle Portius, Miss Ford Shoppy. She has spent wonderful years together with us here. At this time, I just want to greet, acknowledge the Holy Spirit in our midst, then the officiating ministers, Bishop Audley Miller, Bishop Lee War Gordon, Pastor Carlton Burton, my co-host, Mr. Clifford Copes, family members, choir members of this church, children, visitors. I greet you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We thank God for such a wonderful life. She was a happy woman, and I can say, she gone home to be with her Lord. At this time, I'm going to call on Abby Williams and Jaden Abdullah, grandchildren, to do the first lesson, Revelation 21, from 1 to 10, as you come at this time.
Thank you. Good morning, church. Today's scripture reading will be taken from Revelation 21, verse 1 to 10. Please stand when you found it.
And it reads, "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride for her adorned husband. And I heard a great voice from heaven saying, 'Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with him, and they shall be with his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. And thy God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, nor shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away.' And that he sat upon the throne said, 'Behold, I made all things new.' And he said unto me, 'Write, for these words are true and faithful.'"
And he said unto me, "It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is the authorist of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful and unbelieving, and the abominable and murderers, and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake, which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. And there came unto me one of the seven angels, which had the seven vials full of the seven last plagues, and talked with me, saying, 'Come hither, I will shew thee the bride, the Lamb's wife.' And he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and shewed me that great city, the holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God." Here endeth the reading of God's holy word. Let us honor it by saying amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Thank you for that lesson. I must also acknowledge another pastor in our midst, Pastor Pamelia McIntosh. And if there's any other pastors in the midst, greeting this morning. We'll be going to the tributes, and you'll come in this order: Kiana Porcious, granddaughter; Barbara Porcious, daughter; and Stevie Watkins. You come in this order. "I am going home on the morning train. I am going home on the morning train. For the evening train will be too late. I am going home on the morning train."
Good morning, everyone. A tribute to my treasured grandma. This is a post that is difficult for me to write. Recently, I lost my beloved grandmother, who passed suddenly. We will miss her terribly. She was one special lady, and the loss of her is felt deeply by many. Even though she lived a full life, fought through illnesses due to aging, and seeing her suffering in those last hours was extremely difficult. The love of grandma is unique. God must have given grandmothers to us to liven up our lives, to make our lives more complete, to make us well-rounded and better human beings. She played a big part in my childhood, and I can remember so many times sitting in her kitchen and tasting the dish she prepared with special love. She taught me a lot about love and the meaning of family. She was never been just my grandmother, but my guardian, my friend, and my inspiration.
I am Barbara Porteous, the fourth child of Myrtle Porteous. Fellow mourners, we are gathered here today to celebrate the memory of Myrtle Porteous. We honor here today a woman who was of great dignity and noble character, and one of who was proud of her Jamaican heritage. During my life, I developed an admiration for her outstanding ability, skills, and I have felt the utmost confidence in her upright, inspiring character and outlook as a parent and provider. Her mother, Myrtle, was one of the most unforgettable persons I have ever met. She had a superb gentleness and understanding. But the real joy of knowing her was her commitment to the development of her fellow human beings. I have come to the realization that we are richer in spirit and wiser in her vision for having Myrtle Porteous as our parent. Words are inadequate to communicate our great pain as we celebrate, but also say farewell to a woman of whom, paraphrasing William Shakespeare's words, her life was gentle and the element was so mixed in her that the nature might stand on its feet and say to all the world, this was a woman. As is evidenced by her presence here today, we do ourselves and our community, Mount Peace District, a great honor in saluting the memory of one for whom, had I been a Jamaican poet, I have defined as a noble Jamaican. This is because she was so faithful to the land of her birth, so strong in her devotion and in her enduring honor of Jamaica. All these we saw and admire as they made a profound impression on her thoughts. Myrtle, our mother, was sustained by the sincerity of her Christian faith. She was born, raised, and nurtured in the bosom of the church, where she was nourished by the words and principle of the Christian faith, and where the words of the Holy Bible were her inspiration. Our Mother Myrtle lived beyond the biblically allocated 70 years. Therefore, reflecting the words of the French writer who said, "The advantage of living is not measured by the length, but by the use." Some men have lived long, others live little. Attend to it while you are in it. It lies in your will, not in the number of years, for you to have lived enough. Myrtle believed that here on earth, God's work must be truly be our own. Therefore, her life's work reflected well. John 9 and verse 4. I must work the work of him that sent me while it is day. Myrtle met the approach of death with a steady eye. In that, mother walked with death, as if death were a companion, an acquaintance whom she recognized but did not fear. In the end, death came as a friend, and she fell asleep, as every man and woman who strive to fear God may hope to do. During this period of mourning and meditation, may we draw comfort for today and strength for the future from her bearing and her fortitude. To the Porteous family, I know it may be of some comfort to you all to know that although our beloved mother, Myrtle Porteous, has gone on ahead, her life among us was not in vain, as her principles and dedication will be guidelines to the rest of us for as long as we live. Let us take comfort in the words of Alan Curtis' poem, Rest. The memories and the love I leave behind are yours to keep. I have found my rest. I have turned my face to the sun, and now I sleep. Now a devoted family and loving friend, or defined, is a wise counsel, courage, inspiration, love, and trust that O Mother Myrtle gave. To our beloved community, Mount Peace District, as is evidenced by our presence here today, and who share the pain of the loss of Myrtle, I hope the words of John Bunyan in Pilgrim Progress will offer you all some comfort. I see myself now at the end of my journey. I am going to see that head which was crowned with thorns, and that face which was spat upon for me. I have formerly lived by hearsay and faith, but now I go where I shall live by sight, and shall be with him in whose company I shall delight myself. Myrtle Porteous, we thank God for your unconquerable soul during our life's journey here on earth. Your head was blooded many times, but you remain unbowed. I close and say farewell. Good night, my sweet princess. May the light of angel take you to your eternal rest. As we take Myrtle Porteous, Myrtle remains to her final resting place. Mother Earth, please receive her into your tender care. Hold her tight, keep her warm, and comfort her as she sleeps. Thank you.
Bless the Lord. Thank you, Miss Barbara. She'd want to say, hold on, my child. Joy comes in the morning, weeping only lasts for a night. God bless you, Mr. Steve. Bless the Lord.
Shall we praise the Lord? Somebody praise the Lord. Indeed, God is a good God. And we ought to give him thanks. Amen? Amen.
Hallelujah.
Have you a river you cannot cross, a mountain so hard to climb? Have you a mountain you can't hold on to the old rock? filled with heartaches and sorrows, where loved ones are taken away.
Cross. Someday, someday, Jesus will come. Thank you, my brother. Coming to us with a selection will be Shakira and Mohisha Cope, Run Daughters. Hallelujah. The song says, is your name written there in the Lamb's Book of Life? Roll call, brother, sister, roll call. Roll call, roll call. Roll call, roll call. There's a meeting up in heaven. Roll call, is your name written there in the Lamb's Book of Life? Roll call, brother, sister.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning.
Tell me, what does it look like in heaven? Is it peaceful? Is it free like they say? Does the sun shine bright forever? And the fear and the pain gone away? 'Cause here on high it feels like everything good is missing since you left. And here on earth everything's different. There's an emptiness. Oh, I hope you're dancing in the sky. And I hope you're singing in the angels' choir. And I hope the angels know what they have.
That is born of a woman is a few days and full of trouble. It is appointed unto man once to die, but after this, the judgment. Grandchildren, your grandma would want to tell you, prepare to meet your God, because there will be coming a day, there will be coming a day when you got to give an account for your sins. Thank you for that wonderful rendition. The second lesson taken from Ecclesiastes 3:1-8, Tajay, Leslie, and Aaliyah Porteous, grandchildren. Can you please come at this time?
Good morning, church.
Today we'll be reading Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. To everything there's a season, a time to every purpose under the sun, under heaven, a time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance,
a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to keep silence and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. This is the reading of God's holy word, and we honor it by saying amen.
Amen.
I mean, say, oh, you are going to walk with God, on that great day, on that great day, oh, my Lord. Say, oh, we are going to walk with God, on that great day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you for that lesson. Remembrance, Mistress Arlene Porteous, all daughter. Come, let us have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our trouble. Hear our faintest cry, answered by and by. Feel a little fire is burning. Know a little fire returning. Have a little talk with Jesus, make it right. Have a little talk with Jesus. Tell him all about our trouble. Hear our faintest cry. Answer by and by. Feel a little fire is burning. Know a little fire returning. Have a little talk with Jesus. Makes it
pleasant good morning to each and everyone. I don't know where to begin. I have so memory of Mama. It would take days for me to explain, but I'm gonna be brief. A mother love is always with her children. Losing a mother is one of the deepest sorrow a heart knows. Today, I am grieving the death of my mother. I remember my mama in a happy way. As Shirley Caesar once quote, I do love that song. We went to school with old in our shoes. We didn't have much, but the Lord showed us through. Mama kept the family together. Yes, she did. I remember mama in a happy way. My mother was one of the most loving and caring person one could have ever met. Growing up with mama, I couldn't understand. Sometimes she used parable phrase to get her words across. And I would like, sometimes, mama, you're too torment, man. But as I grow into a woman, her words manifest in me, and I know exactly what she was trying to embrace in me. Mama is a woman that sometimes her sister and brother children, the way she cares for them, you are like, mama, why are you so worried about? Like Desiree, and I remember Desiree had a situation once, and it take a toll on her. She could not sleep every day. She would be like, what happened to Desiree? You know, Elaine was sick. It's like Elaine was her own. Donna, the same thing. And I remember she would welcome each and every family to her home. When she cooks, she has to use a big pot, you know, because everyone has to be fed. And Chris was living with us once, Marlon, Tanisha, and Nick. And I would be like, mama, where are you going to find room for so many people? She would be like, Miguel, you no worry yourself. As long as they can find one corner for lay down, make them turn. Because at least me can swear for them meanings and call them. But if they come, they have to survive. So mama was caring. And you know, she likes funeral. I would plan funeral trips with her. And whenever morning for funeral, she would be ready. And girl, me no want late, you know, because guess what? Me want one front seat and make sure me get me program. You know that everyone dies in the community, she would get a program and she would save them up. I'm like, mama, I'm gonna clean and throw these away if you think you're bad touch one. So everyone died, like even ears, you can ask her, she will tell you. Let me go see, because me know for me, make sure me get the program. So she had so many dreams and aspirations. I started to write, but I stopped. Because why write something about mama? You know, because I've lived with her and I know what she likes. I've been there with her, you know. Mama had this dream. She always tell me, girl, let me tell you something. You see anything you want in a life, dream big. Anyway, come. You say, sometimes if you don't have the money, just please say you're rich, because you will get money. So anyway, she always have this, you know, intention of going away. So when she saw the airplane going on, you big bird, one day I going to see dog in a hono. And I can remember the first day when my sister, you know, got her to come visit in England. I was at the airport. Those words started coming back to me and I started crying. And I said, mama always said, dream big, you know, and just have hope. And she said, you know what? Me now watch the nice of the market, you know, Miss P, because if I even when somebody they eat then dinner, me we drink me tea. So you will not grudge nobody. Just take time and satisfy with what you got. I'm talking it just the way she would tell us, you know. I remember going to school. We didn't have much, like Shirley Caesar said. But it was the happiest time for us when we come home from school, that home sweet home light would light up and all nine of us would gather around that home sweet home light and we asked to do our homework. And what sometimes I would couldn't wait for mama and brother P, my daddy, to get into argument because they had a way of pronunciation. So my father would say double. My mother would say double. My father would say W. My mother would say Z. My father said EZ. He said, I know, so you go. And then they started. So I would love that when they get it. So then they, you know, all break up. And then they tell us dopey stories. And then we that join us together. I wish people could be telling more dopey stories because those things, you know, draw us close to each other. You know? And she would like had nine of us. So in the afternoon, we have to cook. I was the eldest daughter, so you know I have to do most. And I have to cook for everyone, 13 person, 11 person, because everyone that comes along to mama's house has to eat. Mama, you know, me not share the food tonight. Y'all no ramp with me. Sit down, you're going to teach you how to share. And she would put all nine plates out, and she start and go around and then come back and make sure everyone. Then I said, mama, where's your plate? Girl, me no want nothing, you know. You make sure no eat and well no eat and left me we eat. So me and Barbara always watched her and put something back in it. And then Steve would slide it out to the side. You know? So Steve was always the troublemaker. So anyway, one day I was going to the river to wash. I'm talking about, you know, the way she used her method to taught us love. Going to the river, because, you know, we all have to grow in a Kappa River, you know. So got my linens ready in the tub, soap and everything. And Steve was a grown one. Me and him were supposed to go to the river. He sneaked his linens under the bottom of my, you know. When I went to the river, Steve down a Kappa swimming. Me can't swim enough, and me have to wash all the dirty clothes. So when I, meanwhile, washing. Me say, but where's Steve? What happened to why Steve clothes, you know, in my tub? And I pack them, take them home dirty, didn't wash them. Come said, I'm gonna complain now. To my surprise, when I get home, y'all, where you take them home back dirty for? Me say, mama, Steve run a river and didn't wash them. He said, let me tell you something. You're going to go back run a river and you're going to wash them. I said, I start crying now. I said, Lord have mercy. I thought I would win. No, I have to go back run a river. He said, look, I tell you something. Never render evil for evil. Never render evil for evil. If somebody do you bad, you do them good. So you're going to go back run a river and wash the clothes and then carry it back. And I did. And I learned from that. You know, she said to me when I started working, she was like, Miss P, let me tell you something. And how much you work, you know, and how much you save. Anytime you work, if you work a dollar, put down a 5 and 25 cents. And you know, those things, you know, lives on in me. Mama is always encouraging, and she has a way of bringing her words out, but it makes sense. And I didn't realize then until I grow older. And every day, her memories live on in me. You know, so I stand here this afternoon looking at all of us with tears in the tracks of tears in our eyes, can tell the love we share for Mama. Mama, did you ever know how much I love you? You're everything I wish I could be. I can fly higher than an eagle this morning because, Mama, you are the winds beneath my wing. I will always cherish your memories we spend together, and your every moment, and hold every moment close to my heart. Mama, you are very special, and the love and aspiration and the warm feelings you have for your grandchildren, and I do hope it manifests throughout all of us, and we will hold each other close the way she taught us. Thank you very much.
A virtuous woman has fought a good fight, has finished her course, and has kept the faith. I had a privilege to visit her in her last days. Members of this church and myself, we went to visit an afternoon after fasting here, and she was celebrating. We had a wonderful time around the house. She was so excited. She was in high spirit, knowing that one day she will meet her maker. And she's only sleeping until she hear that call. So she want to tell you all, families and friends and church families, make sure you're calling. It's an election, sure. Bless you. Mr. Patrick Jones had to leave, so at this time I'm going to call on him, Mr. Patrick Jones, with his tribute. Yes, I said he has to leave, so I'm calling him at this time. I'm glad Jesus saved me one day, and he took me out of bondage one day. I know I'm on my way to Canaan's happy land. I'm glad Jesus saved me one day. I'm glad Jesus saved me one day, and he took me out of bondage one day.
Good afternoon. It's a very good pleasure being here and seeing so many family members that I haven't seen in a long time, and the new ones that I just met. Hello. Now, I cannot just come here and it's about Miss Ford, but I can't just talk about Miss Ford. This is a strand of all these wonderful people that set the way for us. We as younger generation. So I'm going to start by saying Uncle Caria. If you guys remember Uncle Caria, he's a brother of Miss Ford. Now, Uncle Caria, his thing is coming to my grandma's door every day, actually gate, and he wants a fire stick. You have to get him a fire stick because we want to build him tobacco. Then we're going to talk about Miss Mac. Now, Miss Mac is a sister of Miss Ford. And the reason why I'm talking about these people, that's my memories. And these are the people that I remember growing up that I look up to for a lot of different reasons. And for the part that I'm traveling now is because of their ideology, their belief. And I have to say, Miss Mac, my memory of her is coming down to my yard when I was living in Johnstown with my mom. And she always got to go. She always in a rush. She always got somewhere to go. And mommy got always said to her, no, just stay for the night. And she want to go. She have to go Jericho. She have to go Q all over the place. Then, next person is Auntie Jenny. Auntie Jenny is another sister. And Miss Jenny, my memory of her now is going up the street, up the road. It's a pleasure for you. Hurry up, go over to her house. Because I know she's always in the kitchen. I roast her breadfruit. I fry something. And she's going to give me some food. All right? So, you know, I have to talk about that. Uncle Hector, he's a man of not a lot of words. Okay, he was just like my grandfather. If you say hi, he's only, These guys, they don't talk. And up until today, I just came. I haven't seen the man in like 4 years. Like, Uncle Hector, how you doing? That's it. Right? So, now we got to talk about Auntie Ford. And the reason there's more siblings, but I didn't know, I never met them. So I'm talking about my experience with the ones that I know. The one I knew, actually. But now, Auntie Ford, she always have a smile on her face. And you can't miss her. She was the brownest one out of all of them. And I never can say anything negative. If she see me out the road, I might get in a little scruffle or a contention with somebody. Growing up as a kid, the only thing she said, boy, go on out to your granny yard. That's it. And, you know, me and Gracie, I mean, Miss P, everybody, they treat me good as a kid. And it's just a pity that we're here to mourn the loss of Miss Ford, and we're not here to have a family reunion to celebrate life, because the family is big and we need to get together more often to celebrate that. We living and we here now. We have to show respect to Miss Ford and it's life, and we all got our day. And again, I have not more to say because I gotta go, but I hope you guys have a wonderful day and rest in peace, Miss Ford. And do your thing. All right.
Bless you. She's doing her thing. Because she has left a legacy here. She was such a woman. Because most of her children was member of this church or some other church, if not all. And I know that, as Sister Arlene says, the song that Shirley Caesar sings, went to school with holes in her shoes. You have to find a good type of a mother that stand up with her children and to teach them the way to salvation. And most of you are singers and you love the Lord. Continue, even though she is dead and gone, continue to respect and obey what she has left for you to follow. At this time, selection by Mr. Clive Porcious, son.
Very good afternoon, folks. Before I begin, I will have to make some corrections, because I stood out there and I would have heard we are pronouncing the name incorrectly. It is not Porcious. Me no name Porcious. My name is Clive Porteous. So I am asking us, ma'am, sir, and the crowd, the congregation, it is not Porcious, it is Porteous. Remember that one. You see, I am from the tribe of Porteous, and I know how my father would have reacted to things. You know, I spent a little time with him, a little time with Miss Ford, and I heard the conversation sometimes, you know, so some correction has to be made, all right? But it's good to be here, friends. And this morning, I do have a challenging time to get here, because I have to went to Save Lamar this morning, because I'm on my foot, my mobile is down. So, you know, to get here, you know, it's a challenge. I could not be here Wednesday because same problem with transportation. But even if I was have to walk to get here today from my home, you know, I would have to leave a little earlier to get here on time. But it's good to be here, friends. It's good to be here. It's a sad occasion to know that we have to meet in this way as a family. You know, because I haven't seen some of my brothers and sisters for a long while. So it's good to be here. However, it's a sad occasion. But I want to say something to us, friends. It doesn't matter how many people would have died from a family. We still cannot get used to death. Mark that down. Even if all would have died on one leave, we still cannot get used to death. And if we go back to Hebrews 9 and verse 27, it reminded us, it is appointed unto man once to die. Just take a good, because many of us are very good readers. Look carefully on the sentence. It is not we who made an appointment with death. Look again, check it out. It is not we who would have made an appointment with death. Death has an appointment with us. So whenever time it comes, it is not going to reverse. We just have to go. The wise man Solomon reminded us in Ecclesiastes 12 and verse 14 that everything will come into judgment. Even some of the secret things that Brother P and Miss Ford never know about, it will come into judgment. So we must prepare, friends, for these two things, death and the judgment. May, as we would have here today, to celebrate the life of Miss Ford, I would say to us, especially to my brothers and sisters and nieces and nephews and cousins and you name it, all of us, it is appointed unto us. Make sure that our calling and election are sure. There is coming a day when our heartache shall cause no more cloud in the sky, no more tears to dim the eyes. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, a glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus, I shall see, oh, just to look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he take me by the hand and lead me through that promised land. What a day, a glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness or pain, no more parting over there, and forever with the one who died
today a glorious day that will. I'm gonna sing the verse again for us. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness or pain, no more parting over there. And forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, a glorious day. Saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through that promised land. What a day, a glorious day. The one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and lead me through the promised land. What a day, a glorious day.
Precious is the sight of the Lord, is the death of his saints. Bless the Lord. The third lesson, 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 58. Sashana Portia. All these years we are saying Precious. I'm sure it's not only me. Porcious, Porcious. So I beg your pardon, my dear. Okay, Porcious.
Good morning. Our scripture is taken from 1 Corinthians 15, 51 to 58. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed.
In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we all shall be changed.
For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality.
So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass with the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory.
O death, where is our sting? O has, where is our victory?
The string of death is a sin, and the strength of sin is the law.
But thanks be to God, who given us the victory throughout our Lord Jesus Christ.
Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abundant in the work of the Lord, knowing that the labor is not in vain in the Lord. Thank you.
Bless the Lord. Thank you. Mistress Gracie Porteous Leslie and Vilma Porteous and Jaden Abdullah, children and grandson, will be coming with a selection at this time.
Thought with you today, a thought about my mother, a meek, a sweet, a gentle spirit, a smile like no other. The strength she possessed, the character she showed, the love of her heart was grande. Her jovial ways, her astounding grace, her wisdom suppressed all other. Yes, virtuous indeed. The purest of soul, God's gift to all. Oh, what pleasure to sit at her feet, to listen to her speak of life of God and all his wonders. She poured her all into us to ensure we had a better future. She was no one to sit back as the world passed by. She rode every wave, yes, every high tide. Her mountains were rocky, her valleys were flat. Yes, she accomplished her dreams because she journeyed with God. She knew the secret place of prayer and often communed there with her Father. This, she said, was a secret to life, the joy and the strength that she had. Now we stand here today, our hearts are broken, our spirit contrite, many tears we have shed, many thoughts remembered, many memories of her mother, so clear, yes, so bright. Every day God gave her to us, we will always cherish. Not one second will be forgotten. Every moment we will value. We are honored to be her children, yes, her family. And we, as we say our goodbyes today, we know it will not be forever. Because one of these days, we will see her again, the way God intends life to be. And when the time comes, it will be forever, because God promised us that death had no victory. We love you, Mama, so long, until we meet again.
A place that's called heaven. It's made for the pure and the free. This is truth in God's words he has given. How
for God's hand.
children will play without sadness. The women will dance without fear. And the men will want to with wonder. Holy light, peace, and love will be there. How beautiful heaven must be. Sweet home of the happy and free.
Can we all just imagine how beautiful heaven's gonna be? Can we just imagine it for a moment? Oh my God. There is going to be a meeting in the air, in the sweet, sweet by and by. God shall wipe away all tears from our eyes. And because of that, we have an assurance that we will see our King of Kings and our Lord of Lords. If we put our act together and choose Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior and prepare to meet Him at the bank of the beautiful shore, because whether you're ready or not, Jesus is coming. Jesus is coming. Prepare to meet the God. I'll be taking myself out of the way and invite my co-host to come to continue the rest of the program. But before he comes, I'm going to leave this song. I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry. I've answered the master call. Jesus took my heavy load. Now I'm on the glory road. I'm not sorry. Oh,
Shall we bless the Lord again? Shall we bless the Lord again? Hallelujah. Let us all stand. Let us all stand. Let us all stand. Wait, are you ready or not? Wait, are you ready or not? It's coming again. Shall we bless the Lord?
Bless the Lord.
Shall we bless the Lord again? Wait, are we ready or not? My Jesus is coming. Coming again. Hallelujah. Nine of us. I am the first one. Hallelujah. And it's so hard to bid farewell to your mother. It's very painful to bid farewell to her. But regardless of what, you have to be strong. You have to be strong. And I'm here to say to my sisters and brother this afternoon, our mother has fought a good fight. I'm going to ask every one of you, sister and brother, are you fighting the good fight? Are we fighting the fight that our mother fought? I don't want any answer. But our mother fought a good fight. Shall we bless the Lord? Shall we bless the Lord again? as my sister said before her, our mother grew up us out of nothing. Out of nothing. Maybe they are ashamed to say to you this day that sometimes the food share in the plate. But there's no meat nor no fish in it. And sometimes she said, I'd rather throw at the pot and throw water in it. And then somebody would hear that something is going on in the kitchen more than beg somebody something. And I always wonder why she say that. But she say when the pot is hot, you get it real hot. And when you throw the water in it, some nice have to make. Maybe some of you here don't have that experience. But my hardest of sisters and brothers, they have the experience. But today we are proud. We are very proud. And we are proud the way that she's going home. Hallelujah. You're going to turn to your hymnal and we're going to collect an offering. This is the last contribution that my mother will be giving to this church. I'm going to ask you to give what you can. Shall we bless the Lord? As I journey through this land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary. Which soul are you pointing to Calvary this day? Are you pointing a soul to Calvary? Let us get the music them together. As I journey through this land. As I journey through this land, singing as I go, pointing souls to Calvary.
To the crimson flows,
many arrows pierce my soul
from the dark. But the Lord leads me on, through Him I must lead.
Yeah.
Yes, the Lord.
Hallelujah. How I want to see him. Hallelujah. Just to look upon his face.
Yes, Lord.
The songwriter said, little is much when God is in it. Labor not for wealth or fame. Some of you don't understand what our brother is trying to say. Some of you don't have such a mother that when the dinner cook, they don't get any at all. They only get what you call the pot water to drink. They put their children first. And you know the saddest thing about everything? Some of those mothers are so unfortunate that whenever they are sick unto death, those same children, they are nowhere to be found. Nowhere to be found. Children, take care of your parents. It is across the board. Your parents is very important. They need you. Don't say that they live their life already. Jesus, let us pray. Father God, just want to thank you for every hands that give to you today, God. Father God, I pray that you bless every soul that gave, and even those was unable to give at this time. Good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and run it over. And Lord, you sanctify this offering. Whatever it's going to use to do, God, you will be blessed from it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Bless the Lord. Miss Winsome Anson and Elaine McKellar, niece, will be coming to us at this time with a tribute.
Say good afternoon to everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. Really happy and really sad. I remember the last time I was standing here, I remember I was doing the eulogy and I said, who next? And if Miss P could vividly remember, she said, Elaine, don't ask that question. You see? Well, it has been a while. And we are here to celebrate the life of a good woman. You can cry if you want to cry. Because tears are a language only God understands. But the life that she lives speaks this afternoon for her. It speaks with volume for her this afternoon. So, children, auntie, uncle, cousin, brother, sister, nieces, and nephew, hold the fort. Hold the fort. I am dancing in the Lord because you know why I'm dancing? Because I know where I am going. And this afternoon, if you don't know where you are going, you don't know the joys of salvation. I remember, I can give you a script. I remember when my auntie died, I think it was Miss Mac. I was doing the eulogy. And they were singing this song. I can't remember. It is well with my soul. I couldn't sing it because I know it wasn't well. But you know, today, I can say it is well with my soul. I know where I'm going. And so this afternoon, cry if you want, cry. She has gone home. There was nothing to hold her here. Her eyes has caught the glimpse of heaven. And she's rejoicing today. So all who know, put on their shoes and ready to run. Let today be an example of a life that is well lived for Christ. Buckle up your shoes and start to run the kawa. No turning back. And it will be sad. And that day, when she come and they look for children and in grandchildren and in nieces and in nephew, and some man also there, it will be a sad occasion. So this afternoon, all those who need to get ready, get ready. Come on board. It is not hard to be a Christian. It is not hard. When I was out in the world, me didn't have no much pleasure. Now me can dance as me want to dance. Me can do anything because what salvation is free. No born here, no. He no born any one of us. Only if we just take the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior. Commit our ways to him. Ask him to guide us. Ask him to protect us. Ask him to lead us. And he will this afternoon. So this afternoon, children, grandchildren, nieces, nephew, me. Me no call him Miss Wood. Me auntie. Who know that the name there? Me auntie. Okay. So whatever the song that we're about to sing, it is already. Song already. So we have to revert to something else. So here we comes.
Precious memories and seen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me, precious sacred season
certain that all of you family members, you have a whole lot. You have a whole lot. Thank you, sisters, for such a wonderful song. Gonna call in Mistress Shaniqua Hall Shue, granddaughter, to come with a tribute at this time, followed by grandson Demar James.
Shaniqua, and I'm Miss Ford, or Miss Myrtle Porteous, first grandchild. Mama was the stalwart of her family and the tower of her strength. She wore a contagious smile on her face, her peaceful spirit, optimism, and positivity emulated at all times. My fondest memories of my grandmother are when my cousins and I rode in the donkey's hamper to Kemshot District for her working. She prepared corned pork with boiled ground provision such as St. Vincent yam, yellow yam, dasheen, cocoa, and flour dumplings. She shared our meals in banana leaves and calabash. The ladies weeded the grass, the men tilled the soil, while my cousins and I rolled in the meadows, picked fresh seasonal fruits. On our way home from working, my grandmother would stop at Copper River. She washed our clothes, bathed us, and headed home to prepare dinner for the whole family. 24 hours to me seemed like limited time. However, to Mama, she always managed to fit all her complex tasks within 24 hours and never complained. She is the epitome of a hard-working woman. Her home remedies cured any illnesses. Her bay rum was used to anoint our joints, and the pain subsided immediately. Eucalyptus and honey with a hint of lime cleared our colds. There are many more remedies, but I just named a few. I was around for the birth of most of my cousins. Mama accompanied my aunts and her daughter-in-laws to the hospital for the delivery of most of her grandchildren. She prepared her home for the return of her new grandbabies. She sat by the bedside and nursed the babies through the night and allowed the new mothers to sleep. She sang sweet lullabies and rocked my cousins and my brothers to sleep. The main entertainment at Mama's house was at nighttime, either around the fire or on the veranda. We laughed, we prayed, we played, we sang together. Mama had the most melodious voice. She told us stories about rolling calves, Anansi the spider, and Big Boy. She told us about her experiences, how she rode on the market truck with Miss Conn, Miss Gwendolyn, Miss Mary, and Miss Hortense. She told us about growing up with her sister, Aunt Tiny, Auntie Jenny, which visited Grandmama frequently and spent the whole night talking and laughing, Miss Mack, and her brother Ekta. She shared that her and her sisters enjoyed dressing up and dancing to quadrille, mento, and kumina. She shared her family heritage with us and encouraged us to have good relationship with all our family members. She especially spoke about Bob and Babette, how mannerly they are, Charlene, Desreen, Donna, Elaine, and Lurleen, otherwise called Daughter. Her eyes lit up as she spoke about them. On Sundays, my mother, Miss P, prepared traditional Sunday dinner. Yet, I made my way to Mama's house for her Sunday dinner. My aunts and uncles, over the years, took it as a joke. They would ask me, whose cooking was better? Mine, my mother's, or our Mama's? And my response was always, Mama's cooking was the greatest, of course, with a bright smile on my face. Mama's cooking is the greatest. Oh yes, I have to confess. My brother, Toussaint, AKA Chuddy, she said, Shanika, make sure say you go up there today, you know, and make sure say you mention say Mama red pea soup was the best. Me will love Mama red pea soup, you know. When me go up there, me whop up a couple bowl. Trust me, me love me food. My brother Brady, Aldwayne Hall, said he has lost his best friend. He was there with Mama as her pillar of strength during her illnesses. He carried her, fed her, and sang her lullabies. He definitely paid it forward. I will miss Mama's cooking, her stories, under encouragement. Her motivation has molded our childhood. We had such meaningful memories. I can truly say that, Mama, you molded our childhood and taught us what humble beginnings are. Thank you, Mama. We love you and miss you. Rest well in heaven.
With God, on that great day, on that great day, oh my Lord, so we are going to walk with God, on that great day. Has Mr. DeMar James come along?
I will be reading Damar's tribute, seeing that he couldn't make it here. Mama, Miss Ford, Myrtle Porteous, however you are addressed by the many that adored you, one thing incomparable in each and every individual who have had the pleasure of crossing paths with you throughout your days is how wonderful of a person you were. And I know deep down your warm, welcoming, amicable, thoughtful, respectful, endearing love characteristics will forever resonate within all of us. We were truly blessed by God with your arrival into this world, as without the contributions, your life, the dedication, the endless efforts, hard work, your sufferings, your wits, your wisdom, throughout a period of time when life was hard for individuals with only one, you gave life with 9 children, who should all feel blessed to have the opportunity to call you mother. Mama, likewise, the many grandchildren and great-grandchildren that have sprung from your offsprings, also had the pleasure of embracing your kind, caring, comforting actions or words. I cannot imagine composing a tribute that will ever be lengthy enough or to include the many descriptive words to enlighten those who would not truly know how special you were to myself especially, but also to the entire family, friends, and acquaintances. I am who I am today because of the ways of life, the morals, the numerous quotations, tales, and stories of indoctrinated us with and elaborated on with joyous laughter. Mama, you were the meaning of loyalty, strength, devotion, courage, true love, friendship, as your life entailed it all. I never had to search far when I required an answer of what certain things were meant to be, as I saw them all in you. They should have named you Miracle instead of Myrtle. For me, you were like a second mother. I can openly speak on behalf of many other grandchildren, as this was the case for them likewise. I do not express my emotions easily or openly, but I will honestly say this. I lost my composure. I never felt so desolate. My tears were and are still non-expendable. When I have a bad day, despite how severe the circumstances, I never fail to remember the things you said. I frequently asked myself, what would Mama say? Then smile before concluding my thoughts or actions. You were my role model. You were my motivation. My example of making all things possible from nothing. Making a little do a lot. Kept smiling even when you're crying inside. You were not a quitter, and I know you never gave up on us. But the Lord said it was time. Time to free you from the bondage of a broken body. Just like the caterpillar from its cocoon, it's to be an angel. You are only now with the ability to continue to watch over all of us. A part of my life has been taken away with your departure, but I seek no solace, comfort, or consolation from those who cannot heal my pain. But I will keep faith in the Lord as the decision was made to elevate you from the burdens of the earth. to be in paradise. No more sorrows, no more sleepless night with agonizing pain. Rest in peace until we meet again. I will miss their voice continuously, hearing you say, Dami, Ardego, just instantly uplift my entire mood, and my smile is obviously uncontrollable, eminently afterwards. To my amazement, this was the same with anyone who met you. You just had that sort of effect on others unknowingly. I will miss your beautiful smile, engaging expressions, and genuine laughter. I will miss your gentle, tender touch. I will surely miss a lot of things about you, and that is definitely a fact. But I will not let our bond be broken by sadness, and I will forever cherish all the glorious memories, positive things that you have inflicted upon me, and extend them. Expand your legacy by instilling your qualities in my children also. Mama, I am only human with limited to capabilities, bound to the acceptance of life, but in my mind, you are still with me, and no one or nothing can erase that, because you were an angel on earth. For now, the best grandmother I could have dreamt of calling my own, Mama, lay your gentle head and rest your peaceful soul. My guardian angel, there's a special place up there for people like you.
Bless the Lord.
www.ascensiontracks.com.
If you give a little more than you take, and if you try to fix more than you break, and if you're the kind who take the time to help a stranger in the rain, there's a place up there for people like you. If you stand up for those underneath, and if you lend a voice to those who cannot speak, if you shine a little light and give sight to the ones who've lost their way, there's a place up there for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold, and when you get there, there's a hand to hold. I believe when your days down here are through, there's a place up there for people like you. If you walk around with a heart on your sleeve, if you try to be the change you want to see, if you lay down your life for love so someone can be saved, there's a place up there for people like you. I've heard up there
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Before we sing, I'm just going to give a little tribute on behalf of the Mount Peace Christian Fellowship family about our dear beloved sister. We had fond memories of Sister Portius. And as Elder Mark says that her memory of her, and one word she used to describe her, is that she was a very compassionate person. And I don't know if you've ever seen someone dance in a wheelchair, but Sister Myrtle Portius thanks for the correction, Portius. Whenever she comes to church, you cannot put her wheelchair anywhere at the back. She has to be up front. And once the singing starts, she would dance her way away. She would dance like crazy. I can remember one Sunday, I believe she went to a funeral. So she came to church late. And when she came in, as she sat down, she sent a message to me. I was doing the service, and she says, I have a song to sing. And when the mic was given to her, she sung, Ride Out Your Storm. And I can tell you that Sunday, the song, it hits every heartstring in every person that was present in that service that day. I cried because, you know, I love that song very much. And today, this afternoon rather, I can tell everyone that I personally believe that she has ridden out her storm. And today, don't look for her here. Don't look for her here. This is not her. Because God has taken the parts of her that belongs to him. Because she has fight that good fight. And I believe that she is in the arms of the blessed Savior. Looking down on everything that is going on here today. With that smile that is always across her face. So let us work to see her on that day when God eventually put in his appearance for those who he has not called home before that great day. God bless you.
Praise God. Praise the Lord.
I'm going home with Jesus in the twinkling of an eye. I made my reservation for a mansion in the sky. I may not know the moment, or I may not know the day, but I know that I'll be living when he calls his church away.
Shall we bless the Lord? Shall we bless the Lord again?
Hallelujah.
Shall we bless the Lord again?
Hallelujah.
Shall we bless the Lord again?
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Said, I know that I believe in. I know that I believe in. The captain of the vessel is calling us to get on board. So if he's not on board as yet, he's calling you to get on board. Get on board. Amen. Said, I know that I believe in. Said, I know that I believe in. Said, I know that I believe in. When he...
Bless the Lord. Sound like we're in a revival. Giving God thanks. Amen. We live to die. So we enjoy life while we have it. And have no regret when it's time to go. The task has been given to me to speak to us, share with us, not Miss Ford, but to share with us all those who are here. And this is a good indication of the life that she lived, to see all of you here celebrating with the family. I came to Mount Peace in 1989, and Miss Ford and the family was one of the first, I believe, that we really begin to have fellowship with. And we still have in it, even though we are apart in different places. Beautiful family. In spite of, it's a going home service for Miss Ford. There are a couple of things I want to just say before I share with us for 10 minutes. Since 1989, I served here until 2004. That's when I left Mount Peace. And in all my encounter with Miss Ford, I have never seen her frown, angry or upset. I don't know if she do it at home when I'm not there, but I have never seen her in any angry mood. And to me, that is outstanding. And in spite of it's a going home service, there's something that I cherish when I was here. And God bless me to hear it again. The voices of Vilma. You like that name still? No. Okay. I'm sorry, Cecilia. Gracie. Barbara didn't sing? Not yet. Okay. You remember those voices, Bishop? Man. Wow. I cherish those moments. And the family, you know, many of them got saved while I was here, to God be the glory. And it sounds like they're still holding the faith, which is very important. Amen? Very important. So let me share with us, I know some of us are hungry by now, right? Yes, man. Here down there? Yes. All horses. It's time for the word. Man shall not live by bread alone. I read for us this afternoon, from Philippians chapter 1, verses 19 through 26. For I know that this will turn out for my deliverance through your prayer and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ. According to my earnest expectation and hope that in nothing I shall be ashamed. But with all boldness, as always, so now also as Christ will be magnified in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me to live is Christ, and to die is to gain. Amen. For to me to live is Christ, and to die is to gain. But if I live on in the flesh, this will mean fruit from my labor. Yet what I shall choose, I cannot tell. For I am hard pressed between the two, having a desire to depart and to be with Christ, which is far better. Nevertheless, to remain in the flesh is more needful for you, the brethren. And being confident of this, I know that I shall remain and continue with you all for your progress and joy of faith. Verse 26, that your rejoicing for me may be more abundant in Jesus Christ by my coming to you again. I know we have sung a lot of songs, beautiful singing, beautiful service. I have a little one to sing as well. After all, this life is over, and much, then I climb upon the mountain top so tall, looking over in the city. Give me grace that I would make it after all. Oh yes, after all, this life is over, and my labor here is ended. Then I climb upon the mountain top so tall, looking over in the city. My Savior is preparing, give me grace that I would make it after all. Oh yes, after all, this life is over, and my labor here is ended, and I... Oh, looking over in the city that my Savior is preparing, give me grace that I would make it after all. Give me grace that I will make it after all. Father, we thank you for your word. Bless your words to the hearts of your people, and glorify your great name. In Jesus' name we ask. Philippians 1:21 says, for me to live is Christ, and to die is to gain. For me to live is similar to the common expression, as far as I am concerned, I'm going to live for the Lord. Nothing else really matters. This is my concern, I'm going to live for the Lord. Paul would experience gain in his own death, because he would be with Christ when he departed from the body. In fact, Paul may have been expressing this confidence that since his imprisonment had furthered the gospel, God would use also his death to further his kingdom. Verse 22, talk about the fruit of my labor. If Paul continued to live, he would have the opportunity to preach the gospel to others and see spiritual victory in the lives of the Philippians' brethren. Paul was in a dilemma because he clearly saw the advantage of both life and death. To die in Christ is to be with him. To live in this life serving the Lord, the opportunity is there to witness and to preach the gospel. So Paul was struggling with these two desires. He knew the best one, but he wanted to be in God's will and do what God would want him to do. So he was in this dilemma because he clearly saw the advantage of both life and death for the Christian. Life means an opportunity to minister to the people, the Philippians, while death means to be with Christ, his Savior, out of earthly trouble. In verse 23, Paul was pressed in on each side, much like a besieged city, with no hope of relief from its affliction. He was torn between the prospect of seeing the Lord and his passion for ministering to the Philippians, his desire. Here means desire is more than a wish. Desire, Paul's desire, was more than a wish. It indicates an intense longing to depart. In relation to Paul's profession as a tent maker, the term depart means to strike or take down the tent and be ready to travel elsewhere. Paul saw death not as the end of life, but as a time of moving from one home to another. And this is the life of the Christians, the believers in Christ. We see death as moving from one home to another, to a better home. I want to challenge you this afternoon and let you know that living for Christ, it brings eternal reward. It brings tremendous blessing, living for God. Amen, somebody. Somebody quote earlier, Hebrews 9:27. It is appointed unto man, yes, once to die, but after death comes the judgment. There's a philosophy going around with some people that you're born, you must enjoy life, eat all you can, drink all you can, live the best life you can. When you're dead, then life is over. I beg to differ, because the word of God differs from that. It is appointed unto man once to die, but after death comes the judgment of God. I want to tell you this afternoon, regardless of what you may have in your lifetime, a life without Christ is an empty one. A life outside of Christ has no real significance nor meaning. And you might tell me about the money in the bank account and the big house. One day you're going to depart from all of those. Amen. So a life in Christ brings eternal reward and blessings. In Luke chapter 12, there's a young man. I preach this many times in funeral services, and it's in my spirit this afternoon. A young man, he was very popular. He was very famous. He was very rich. He had everything to his comfort in his lifetime. But what this young man did not have is nothing for eternity. Amen, somebody. He had nothing for eternity. And he was not very concerned, according to the scripture, about life after death. Just enjoy life now. Glory. Are you there? Praise the Lord. Amen. He had nothing for eternity. All he thought about was himself, his farm, and his well-being. He never knew that he had an appointment. Amen. That death was coming to him. He was not concerned about it. It is a reality that people must be concerned about life and death. Yes. Amen, somebody. Yes. For when we die, there are two places that we will be going. And the life that we live will determine exactly where we go. God no going to put nobody in a heaven. And him not going to send nobody to hell. It is based upon the life and the choices that you make in this lifetime. The Bible says in Matthew 25 that when the King of Glory shall come and sit upon his throne with all the angels there, he's going to call the nations of the earth to come before him.
Come on, somebody. At that great white throne judgment, we all have to appear before our maker. And the Bible says he's going to divide the nation. God going to divide the nation. Not pastors. Not overseers. God going to divide the nations. He's going to say to some, go on my right, and some, go on my left. Those on the right will be declared as the sheep. Those who have served the Lord in this lifetime, and those on the left will be known as the goats. And then he will say to those on his right hand, come with me. He blessed up my Father. Amen. You have served me well. You weathered the storm. You got through your trial. You got through your temptation. You got through your persecution. You got through gossipers. You got through bad mind people. You got through false brethren. But you hold the faith. Oh, glory. Oh, glory. Come on, somebody. I hold on to my faith in God because I take God at his word. Behold, I will come quickly, and my reward is with me to pay every man, every woman, every boy, and every girl for the life that you have lived. Jesus, I feel the Holy Ghost in the house here. Somebody shout a praise in the house here. Mighty God, come on, church of God. He's gonna say to those on his right and come with me. You served me well. You were faithful. You were committed. You give up the world, the goods of the world, the pleasures of the world, and you serve me. People call you all kind of name, church general, church mouse, and whatever they call you. But bless the Lord when that day come. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Somebody's going to be rejoicing and praise God that you did serve him while you were alive. Give him praise, somebody. Give him praise. There are two things in this world, is sure. Guarantee. One is death. And the other is the return of the Lord. And know about them folks that come preach and tell us that the world now come to no end. No worry about them. God going to prove them wrong. Because God is always true. And then he will say to those on his left hand, depart from me, you workers of iniquity. I don't know you. Lord have mercy, bishop, pastors, choirs, and church members. I honestly believe in my heart that some of the people that will be going on the left hand of God will be going to church all the days of them life, but never have a relationship with God. Pastor Pamelia, I believe some preachers going to end up on the left hand of God because all them do is play church and come in for personal gain and prosperity. Come on, somebody. God say, I will supply all your needs according to my riches in glory. And when God, when some church people end up on the left hand there, they're going to come and say, God, I went to church 40 years. I prophesy in your name. Me heal people in your name. And he look in the book and say, but I don't see your name in my book. Glory. Glory.
Glory.
When God tell you to depart from him, there's only one place you have to go. You can't go to London. You can't go to US. I don't have a church here. One place here we go when God said, depart from me, I don't know you. That's what you live for. That is your eternal reward. But for me to live is Christ. I'd rather suffer now, Gracie, and rejoice later than rejoice now and suffer later. Lord God Almighty. Jesus tell us in St. Matthew 24 when he said about earthquake and famines and pestilence, and he said these are just the beginning of sorrows. So for the world the worst is yet to come, but for the church the best is yet to come. Can I say that again? For the world, the worst is yet to come. But for the church, and do I have a believer here? For the church, the best is yet to come. Oh my God, hallelujah. Yes, yes, yes. This young man in Luke chapter 12, he had a farm that was so productive. Everything the man planted grew. Producing. Pumpkin a grow, melon a grow, pomegranate a grow, grape a grow. And the young man sat down one day, amen, my brothers and sisters and friends, and he looked at the farm and he looked at his barn, and he discovered that he's going to have a problem when the harvest time come, because I will not have enough room to store my goods in there. Amen, somebody. And all that while God was listening to that young man, and God allow him to make the decision that he did. People, your life is on a rope. And one day on the one come to the end of on a rope. I would to God when I reach here so I stay good. I did live well. The young man, figure it out. Go and tear down the small barn. Build a bigger one. Store my goods in there. Come on, he never think about nobody, you know. Just himself. Just himself. Jesus, my God. He tear down him small barn, Bishop, and him build a bigger one. Because now nobody partake of his goods. Oh, glory, brother Job said, naked come I into this world, and I'm naked me going go to this world. We brought nothing here. Everything you accomplish from the day you were born, Master God allow you to accomplish them. But one day you're going out to depart from them. Can I tell somebody here this afternoon? Some of you holding on to something that is hurting or not. It is more benefit that you let go of the thing that is hurting you. Can't do without them. When all they're doing is hurting your life. So he built his bigger barn. Church. He reaped his crop. And he locked them in his storeroom. And he sat down. Maybe they never have sofa those days. But him sat down in a chair. Maybe him cut him 10 or 25. And him said to him, soul, relax. Eat and drink. You have good for many years. Are you here this afternoon, church? Are you listening to me? We're soon done. Come on. Amen. Me have enough goods for many years. Me not for big nobody, bother nobody. I am comfortable for now. But this life was in vain. His spiritual life was going down. God allow him to build a big barn, reap him goods and store it in there. And hear this now, hear this now. When he did all of that, and he sat down to take it easy, then God addressed the young man. Whoop. God spoke to the young man. Hear this. God never tell him say him rich. Never tell him say famous. Never tell him say popular. God declare him to be a fool. Because all that he had was for this life. Nothing for eternity. He could not take his grain with him. Amen, somebody. And in one day, that rich man plunder to poverty. Then God asks him the question, who will inherit? Your dead left. To live is Christ. To die is to gain. You gain eternal life when you accept Christ. And you live on into eternity with Christ when this life is over. When this life is over. You know what would be the fitting thing in this service here this afternoon? Is that somebody give their life to God. Maybe a family member. Who not do it yet? This is a fitting opportunity and occasion to join mommy, grandma, auntie, in the kingdom of Almighty God. Don't fool yourself, people. Don't run down the world. The world will wreck you and dispose of you, and life goes on. But a life lived for God is one with eternal reward. Glory. Glory. Oh, glory to God. Hey, somebody praise God in the house here. Yes. Let your word prosper, mighty God, and bring honor to your name.
For the angel in heaven is there to reject us. Say we can't go to heaven as we like. Say we walk as we like, how we talk as we like. Say we can't go to heaven as we like. For the angel in heaven is there to reject us. Can't go to heaven as we like. Church, we walk as we like. And we talk as we like. Say we can't go to heaven as we like. For the angel in heaven is there to reject us. Can't go to heaven. Say we walk as we like. And we talk as we like. Say we can't go to heaven as we like. For the angel in heaven. For the angel in heaven is there to reject us. Can't go to heaven. We all have a choice today. Choose this day who you serve. If God be God, serve him. Bless you, Bishop Miller, for your word from the Lord. Before the eulogy, one Tanisha Porteous will be coming at this time.
I just want to say something. My grandmother, Miss Ford, you know, she took me. When I came here to Mumfies, I was like a troubled child. Everybody know that. Yeah. And she took me here and she loved me so much, teach me so many things. I didn't even know how to bathe myself. And, you know, my grandfather was always the one to beat me. And Miss Ford said, let me put them alone, you know. And I love this lady so much. She, you know, she loved me. She has so much grace with her. Like God give her a double, triple grace. You know, somebody spoke about food. I always remember that. You know, there was so much of us. I wonder why this lady took on the problem. And I used to remember she cooking food like breadfruit and stuff, no meat. And then I used to say, you know, me not say mama da eat. Oh, mama not eat. And she always make sure that we eat. No matter what she have, she always make sure. Mama Miss Ford is not my biological grandmother, but she's the only grandmother I know, and I love and respect her. She's the only grandmother that took care of me, and she teach me about God, because when I came here, you know, coming from Montego Bay, so angry, my parents were separating, you know, she just loved me. and show me love, teach me how to do things, accept me as I am. So that's why anywhere I was, I had to make it here. I wasn't on the program, but I had to show my respect and say, Mama, I love you so much. And I know you're in heaven. It's no joke about that. This great lady loves God. Since I come here and live here as a child, it's no accident. Sometimes things happen in life, it's no accident. I was supposed to be in this woman care. It molded me as an individual and make me who I am today. The thing that she has taught, her grace, her humbleness, make Tanisha who she is today. You understand? And Mama, I love you so much. You're the only grandmother I accept as my grandmother, and everybody knows that. Rest well, Mama. Rest well in heaven.
Thank you, Miss Tanisha. I just want to acknowledge Counselor Barnes in our presence. At this time, we're going to call on Mistress Andrea Dehaney Grant, Deputy Mayor of Lucy, to come with the eulogy at this time. God bless you.
Our moderators, Mrs. Tate and Mr. Cope, officiating pastors and other members of the clergy, Councillor Barnes, my colleague, Councillor, members of the bereaved family, members of the congregation, good afternoon to you. Today I must say that I'm standing here to do this eulogy with a broken heart. For a number of my childhood years, I've lived in this community, and so this family has been very close family to my family, as Miss Ford was my mother's friend. This church that I'm standing in was actually my first school, the first school that I attended. Today, I pray for the family that God will comfort you as you mourn at this time, as he promises in times like these that he'll be close to the brokenhearted and save those who are crushed in the spirit. Eulogy for the late Myrtle McKellar Porteous, affectionately called Miss Ford, Fordy, Shoppy, or New Moon. Life is but a stopping place, a pause in what's to be, a resting place along the way to sweet eternity. Each of us, from the day we were born until the day we die, we are writing our book of life. One might ask, what kind of book did Miss Ford wrote? Book of poems, was it a short story? No matter what type of story this was, I can tell you it is one that worthwhile reading. It's one that will call for us to read night and day. It has many chapters, and it will call for you to read over and over again. This book of life by Miss Ford was a remarkable book that was made of many chapters. This book has taken 83 years, 9 months, and 26 days to be written, which is 1,006 months, which is approximately 30,615 days. And so it will take years for us to read this book, but I'll give you a sneak preview into this book. Just a little moment into this book of Myrtle McKellar Porteous. Chapter 1, Her Birth and Her Upbringing. Let us rewind the hands of time when Miss Ford started writing her book of life. Yes, it was January 12, 1938, when Florence Jenard and Michael McKellar gave birth to a beautiful, beautiful baby girl. As she saw the first glimpse of light and took her first breath of air and cried, what joy she brought to her father and other siblings and the community. At this brilliant moment of joy in the community of Richmond Hill Mount Peace in Hanover was no longer the same. The birth of this baby girl brought joy to the entire community. Growing up with her 6 siblings, 3 sisters, and 3 brothers was indeed a joy by Miss Ford and the rest of the family as they loved each other. Unfortunately, 4 of her siblings predeceased her. in the moment of life, there's debt. And so Miss Ford lost her parents at an early age and was later fostered by Lena and Edward Ginnard. Chapter 2, her education and work. Time went by so quickly, and now it was time for Miss Ford to attend school. She attended Miss Violet Morris School in Mount Peace and later the Clifton Elementary School, where she received her formal education. Miss Ford was a farmer who grew many crops, raised animals, and sold fresh produce. She was also a shopkeeper and an operator. This she did for most of her life. If you go to Miss Ford's shop, with or without money, you could leave with goods. Her shop was the place for the community's members to get help. She would credit her items, and whether or not you pay, you could go back. No was never in her book. Sometimes we wondered what kept the shop alive, but it was her love for people and her love for giving that kept her business going. Chapter 3, her love life and family. Miss Ford was one of the most beautiful young ladies in the community. She was a devoted flower of fashion. She was seen in the way she, this was seen in the way she dressed and the clothes she wore. She was a woman of fashion who loves lovely things, including lipstick, handbags, jewelry, just about anything that enhanced her beauty. She had a very good taste for fine things in life. So no wonder she met and fell in love with Llewellyn Porteous. Her previous marriage, however, produced a son, Billy, and her union with Llewellyn produced 8 children: Leroy, Arlene, Barbara, Devon, Gracie, Christine, Luke, and Vilma. All of her 9 children became one in the union. Although she had 9 children, she was the mother to many, many persons in her community. She opened her doors to anyone in the community and welcomed them. She raised all her grandkids and also many other persons, like Joyce Green, David Green, June Crooks, Christopher Hamilton, Nicholas Porteous, Tanisha Porteous, and many, many, many others. Miss Ford was a woman who was a protector, a disciplinarian, and a friend. She was selfless. She was a loving human being who sacrificed many of her needs and wants for the needs and wants of her children and others in her community. She was a very dedicated and committed person to what she does. She was known to be punctual, polite, hardworking, and kind-hearted. She played the roles of wife and mother to the best of her ability. Chapter 4, Miss Ford, a lover of many things. Miss Ford was a lover of people, especially her family. She loved to visit her children, and she had frequent trips to England and the United States. Miss Ford loved God and her church and was a devoted Christian. Miss Ford loved going to funerals and weddings and could be described as a motivational speaker. She loved to encourage and motivate others. She used phrases and proverbs to bring across her points. Miss Ford loved to smile. Today, I see her children wearing, or maybe not wearing it today presently as they are mourning, but we know that smile because all her children wear that smile. I hope you all can identify that smile, and I hope you can catch it before you leave. Miss Ford loves ackee and saltfish, pork, breadfruit. She loved to wear red. As you see, most of us are wearing red today. That was her favorite color. Chapter 5, the sad moments. Miss Ford was a warrior. Although many forms of illnesses rocked her body over the years, she kept on fighting. Though her ship was rocking and her sails were torn, she continued to rest in the arms of Jesus. Although she lost some members of her body, this did not fade her spirit. Although she was in pain sometimes, some of us didn't know that, her joy and her beauty was always a joy to behold. She was grateful for life, and so she celebrated life each day. She was a faithful servant like Job, and never failed to give thanks despite her challenges. We all have different journeys, different paths along the way. We were meant to learn some things, but never meant to stay. Our destination is a place far greater than we know. For some, the journey's quicker. For some, the journey's slow. On Sunday, November 6, 2021, after fighting a good fight, After writing her in her book of life for 83 years, Miss Ford completed her last chapter of her earthly book. She put her pen down, closed her book, and walked away. She could not stay with us any longer on this earth. To laugh, to love, to play. Tasks left undone must stay that way. Miss Ford made a positive mark on all of us' life. Her hands of the clock were ticking, ticking, ticking. She played her deck of cards that God gave her very well. She wrote many positive pages, and in her book of life, she made many memorable occasions. Her pen was filled with ink. She was writing, 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 but suddenly, oh, the ink was finished. She stopped writing. She closed her eyes, and that resulted in the end of her chapter of life. The church has lost a valuable member. The family has lost their hero. The community has lost a good woman. Her children has lost a loving mother. She has finished her writing. She silently said goodbye to us and goodbye to this world. But oh, let us be reminded and reminisce on the fact that God has been good to us and has given her to us for over 83 years. Thank God for this great book that she has written. And we will endeavor to read and reread this book as it will continue to be a mark on our hearts. Let us all take a chapter from this book. Let us all continue to keep her in our hearts. Let's keep her memories flying. She died leaving 9 children: Billy, Leroy, Arlene, Barbara, Devon, Gracie, Christine, Luke, and Vilma. One sister, one brother, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, daughters-in-law, sons-in-laws, nephews, nieces, and a host of other relatives and friends. A golden heart has stopped beating. Hard-working hands have been laid to rest. God broke our hearts to prove to us He only takes the best. Today, let us remember Miss Ford exactly how she was and celebrate her life as a mother, grandmother, wife, sister, friend, who was indeed a great woman. Mama Ford, we will always cherish your memories. May your soul rest in peace and light perpetual shine on you.
I remember Mama in a happy way. Wonderful memories, continue to cherish them. Thank you, Mistress Dehaney Grant. This time the children will be coming with a floral tribute and a family song.
Thank you. they're living far apart. Although my mom is gone, she's right here in our hearts. We all gonna pull together and stay in the holy place. What?
I remember my mama in a happy way.
Oh, happy.
I remember my mama in a happy way.
You know, I remember my mama when I was about 12 years old. I was going to church, playing church. How many of you used to play church? Let me see your hand. Yeah, some of you still play. And I remember.
Oh, God.
Oh,
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. There is not another person like a mother. Hey! There's not another person like a mother. A mother will put herself in front of a bullet for their child. But there is a difference between the mama and a mother. Children, go live your life knowing that God is God. He is the head controller of your life. Your mother has lived and she has left so many different examples for you to follow. At this time, our dear Bishop Gordon will be coming to us to pray for the families. It was a pleasure serving you. After which, our dear Bishop Ali Miller, he will take over from there. So I'm going to ask the family to seated as the congregation stand. Pastor Bishop Gordon.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. What a woman. What a service. Even nature smiles on us today. And I was asked to do the prayer. I'm going to do that. But I just remain standing. And we need to just end this well. Nobody move. No one move. Stay where you are inside the building. We need to end this well. A community woman, a family woman, a kingdom woman. I remember 1981 serving here as a young man, and I was asked to serve in a different community. In my early 20s, I was 21, 20, 20, 22, 23, somewhere about there. And I was saddened because I love Mount Peace. And Sister Porteous, she called me, and the first time saying this, she called me one side and she said, "Brother Leroy, you're a hard-working young man. Wherever you go, you're going to succeed." She said, "Brother Leroy, you're a hard-working young man. Wherever you go, you will succeed." And it's a testimony of it. A wise woman. Musicians, just rest just for a while, and we're going to pluralize it. For you, we are praying. I want the family to realize that. For you, we are praying. We are praying. For you, we are praying. We are praying for you. Oh God and our Heavenly Father, we thank you. You are God Almighty. You are God of the living. You reigns. You speak and it come to pass. You are Jehovah Jireh. You are our provider. You are our guide. We exalt you, great God. We exalt you. We thank you for your presence with us. We thank you for the Shekinah light of heaven that has shined, is shining, and will continue to shine in our path. We pray for strength for this family. We pray for wisdom for this family. We pray, God, your continual blessing upon this family. You said in your word, we shall above all things that we may prosper and be in good health, even as our soul prospereth. So we claim prosperity. We claim good health. And oh, Father, and we pray, Lord, that those who have not yet committed their life completely in your hand will do so. We pray for guidance, God. We pray, God, you so unite them that the memory of their mother, the memory of Sister Ford will constantly ring in their ears because she has left a legacy behind. Bless the family again. Strengthen the family, God. Continue to grant them vision. Hallelujah. We pray a special covering upon the family and all they do, Lord. And as Jacob, and as, hallelujah, and as Abraham, the blessing will continue to follow their life and their children and their children's children. We stand in agreement. We stand in agreement and consider it done. In Jesus' name. Join me, everyone, and we do the recessional hymn. And at a certain point, the two last verse, we will make our exit. And as I said earlier on, it is very important for you to stay in your inside. The minister will lead the procession, then the pallbearers, then the family, and the congregation follow. And we go in that order. Let's do this song, This Plane I'm Riding.
This plane I'm riding, they say it's living for a place where we'll never die. And the pilot will be my Jesus. To that mansion way up in the skies. So don't be grieving because I'm leaving. And don't you cry when I say goodbye. There'll be no weeping where I'm going. To that mansion way up in the
Goodbye. There'll be no weeping.
As we all be involved.
Oh.
Pastor Burton will be doing an opening prayer, then we do the hymn and the program while the casket goes under. Pastor Burton, let's pray.
Oh Father, God, we worship you and we magnify you. Father God, we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. Oh loving God, there is none like you and there is none to compare unto.
Which one?
Father God, we thank you, Lord, for your life, Almighty God, for our sister, God. Lord, we know that, Almighty God, this is just the part that goes back to the clay, oh God, but you have the part that you will call back, Almighty God, on that day. Father, we bless you and we give you glory, give you honor. Lord, I pray, oh God, as you comfort the family, even now, oh God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father God, we bless you and we give you thanks. And we leave everything in your hands, knowing that, Almighty God, you are more than able to do exceedingly, abundantly above all, as we can ask and even imagine. So, Father, we bless you and we give you thanks. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen. Amen.
Let us join our voices and sing the hymn on the back of the program while the casket goes under. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus.
Loving care of our Heavenly Father, we commend the spirit of our departed loved one and commit her body to the earth, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Anticipating the great resurrection when the dead in Christ will come forth with a new body and endless life with Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. We need to sing the choruses on the program while the workmen finish their job. Again, the final rites. Now unto the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only wise God, the honor, glory, forever and ever. Amen. All the very best to all of you for your holiday. And stay safe. Workmen still have something to do, but we finish here now.
On the land, that deep and rivers, lay down your head upon your Savior's breast. We love you well, for Jesus loves you best. Good night, good night, good night. Only good night, we love it not farewell.
had you in my life.